So we are with Dr. Esther here. Dr. Esther, so what can we do for patients with reaccumulation of their pleural effusion?
So it's common for patients, especially those who have cancer, to have reaccumulation of the pleural effusion. In this case, they can have symptoms again, and this can result in poor quality of life. Hence, for these patients, a procedure can be done, such as a repeat in the pleural tap under local anesthesia to remove the pleural fluid and provide symptom relief. Other more definitive procedures can also be discussed.
So, Dr. Ken, what are our options?
Yeah, so we have a couple of options. Both are equally effective in controlling symptoms, but each have their own advantages and disadvantages. So the first option is talc pleurodesis. Talc is actually a medication. It acts like a mild irritant and causes some inflammation of the pleura. When we administer or introduce talc into the pleural space, the inflammation that it induces actually causes the lung to kind of stick to the inner lining of the chest wall. And if successful, this actually closes up the pleural space and as a result, reduces the risk of significant fluid reaccumulation in the future. But this also means that we do have to insert a chest drain for the patient, which is a soft flexible tube that is inserted into the pleural space. Now, this allows us to remove fluid from the chest and then administer the talc into the pleural space. And this will mean that patients will need to be hospitalized for several days, but the chest drain will be removed before they're discharged from the hospital. One disadvantage of talc pleurodesis is that it does require for the lung to re-expand well and meet the inner lining of the chest wall for it to work. However, there are some patients after removal of the pleural fluid, the lung doesn't expand quite so well. As you can see from this x-ray here, this is the edge of the lung and there's this space that's left there. This will mean that talc pleurodesis will not work for this patient. This can occur in up to 30% of patients with malignant pleural effusions. We can still offer other options for these patients, which I will go on to talk about later. However, if the lung expands well and we administer talc, the success rate is about 70-80%, which means that in every 10 patients, about 7 patients will never require another procedure to remove pleural fluid from the chest because of shortness of breath.
Dr. Ken, are there any more options?
Yes, so the second option is the indwelling pleural catheter or IPC. So the IPC is a soft, flexible tube that we introduce into the pleural space and it allows us to drain fluid from the chest. It's meant to act as a semi-permanent drain, which means that the IPC stays with the patient for as long as it's required to drain fluid. Once the IPC is inserted, we work closely with our patients and their caregivers to teach them how to care for the IPC and how to drain fluid from the chest at home so they will not actually need to come to the hospital. In addition, unlike talc pleurodesis, the IPC does not require there to be adequate lung re-expansion for it to work well. One disadvantage of the IPC is that it does require some degree of inconvenience caring for the IPC, and also there's a risk of infection of the skin and the pleural space, which can occur in about 5-10% of patients. Fortunately, these infections are easily treatable with antibiotics and rarely do we need to remove the IPC because of an infection.
Will the IPC remain there forever?
Not always. In some patients where the fluid stops reaccumulating, we can remove the IPC and this can be easily done as a day case procedure.
Can these procedures be performed upfront at the point of cancer diagnosis?
Yes, so there are some patients who have pleural effusions due to suspected cancer, and we may perform a procedure called a thoracoscopy where we introduce a small camera into the pleural space to get tissue biopsies. And for selected patients, we can actually concurrently administer talc into the pleural space or insert an IPC. And this can help to control symptoms and fluid control in the future and also minimize the number of procedures required for these patients.
But how does a patient choose between the various treatment options?
Well, there's no single best decision, so together with the patient and their families, we'll make a shared decision based on their preferences and their priorities. For example, if their priority is to avoid having to care for a semi-permanent drain, then talc pleurodesis will be recommended. On the other hand, if their priority is to avoid having to have hospital admissions, to reduce the number of days in the hospital, and to avoid having to repeat pleural procedures in the future, then we will recommend for the IPC. In addition, for patients whose lungs do not expand well after fluid removal, we usually also recommend for the IPC. Last but not least, there's always medications that are effective in controlling symptoms that arise from pleural effusion, such as pain and shortness of breath.